Yes, I got some new shades. Thank you for noticing. Welcome to the Daily BA. You know those people that are like, we need to be better scientist practitioners? Well, most times when you dive into those arguments, I think it's a righteous thing to be valuing and moving forward with. But having a framework, really understanding like what is a scientist practitioner model and how do you move forward, like seems most people just kind of fall apart. And it's not to blame anybody or say that anybody's wrong, but I wanted to highlight a resource that was extremely valuable to me to help understand how you go about understanding what the scientist practitioner model is. And it's from a book in 1984, believe it or not. Yes, we are rewinding back over 15 years to talk about this. This beaut here, Scientist Practitioner by Hayes, Barlow, and Nelson Gray. All right, just a quick skimming of the table of contents here so that you can all just, you know, peep on it before you go about buying it. They talk about the Scientist Practitioner, what this model is, and look at this, chapter 2, Managed Care, the future of behavioral healthcare delivery. Nowadays, everyone's struggling and fighting in this managed care delivery model, and we're talking about just the implosion of what's going on in Florida, and a lot of other states have horrible rates as well. But the point is you can find a framework to understand how this is going. These people were talking about this far before our field was struggling with some of the most pertinent issues that we're struggling with today. Now you'll see here, if we dive in, that they have some very specific examples we're talking about here. They talk about panic disorder and agoraphobia, but they're giving you an example and models about how to evaluate research, how to work these things into your current practice models. And what I think is most useful is how you start to integrate this into your delivery model and how do you work on this like reticulated model of taking all the data, taking the experimental analysis, the applied behavior, that sort of research, and bring it all back in together to figure out how to move forward. If there's one thing that the acceptance and commitment therapy community, this RT community, all these folks that go under this label of contextual behavioral science, what they have done extremely well, they know how to work together and move forward. Where behavior analysts are so often just traditionally just arguing and fighting with each other about what should be done and what where things should go, or they're all in their own little camps doing their own thing. These people created a model to move things forward. And this is why I believe we should be looking at resources like this. So you wanna look at time series, within series, between series, combined series. You wanna look at general practice settings and how they're going about replication. You wanna talk about program evaluation. You mean evaluating a program? See, if the insurance companies are ever listening or they're getting really smart, they're gonna start really pressing down on our programs, our different people that are providing service out there and saying, show us what you can do. And I believe that's why we're starting to get some of this pressure in different various states. Just my hunch, no data, but we're going to be tested more and more over time, as we should. You want a section on assessments, and this isn't like a particular assessment. This is how do you go about assessing something. Now, a lot of people complain about acceptance and commitment therapy relying on self-reports. So there's a whole chapter on self-reports and physiological measures you can jump into, as well as direct observation and self-monitoring, some of my favorite. So, with all this, the point is, if you're going to talk about the scientist practitioner model, maybe go to one of the best resources, the definitive resource in behavior analysis to understand what you are talking about before you go about saying those words. It just helps bring our community and strengthen us all and move us forward. 20 pages a day, 15, 20, 30 minutes a day, and you've knocked this thing out in a few weeks. It is that quick and easy. If you're interested in how to kind of hack and bring those sort of things about, be a better person at self-management. We're talking about this on the podcast very soon. Make sure that you check that out. I'm going to link it right here. And now, luckily, I was able to catch up with Steve Hayes, and he was able to share a few words on why this book was written and why it's valuable. So let's go do that.
You know, one of the things that's really cool, I think, about the behavioral tradition is that it's always asked the applied wing to wear multiple hats. If you think about what a behavioral perspective is when you're dealing with an individual with problems, you're bringing in your assessment knowledge, your analytic knowledge, functional analysis, knowledge of treatment outcomes and evidence for it, and being able to pick of all those things, which kernels can I apply here, given the setting, and how will it land? in the person's life. What you're doing right there is you're doing a form of science itself. And in fact, if you were to take the measures and to write down those procedures and to look at how they come to fruition, you're probably doing something which is pretty close to time series thinking, to the kind of within subject ideographic kind of thinking that's part of the behavioral tradition. In the present day, I keep realizing how important the ideographic, not decontextualized individual, but the intensive analysis of the individual or the group couple that you're focusing on and its context, how important that is to be able to understand processes of change. So the scientist practitioner model is not a model that says practitioners should passively receive science and then put a period at the end of that sentence. It's not a model that says that anything that a practitioner thinks is scientific. It's a model that says that we can arrange our interactions, our practical work that we do, in such a way that we're applying scientific thinking to it. And if you just take a few additional steps, that we can actually have it be science and being able to give away what we've learned by that enterprise. And we're dealing with so many people in so many contexts, and sometimes getting paid to do it, maybe not very much, but getting paid to do it. Wouldn't it be cool if that could be the sort of seed corn of the new ideas, procedures, methods, measures that would help liberate the lives of the next person? Yeah, that would be cool. And that's what the behavioral community is up to. And at its best, I think, what it's been able to achieve. So it's time to get back to that old-fashioned religion of being able to both consume and produce, and to take advantage of the models that have already been developed. I do think the scientist practitioner volume walks through some of that, about how to do that and how to think about that. Some of those models that have already been developed as to how to square the circle of being both a person who's delivering services and a person who's developing new knowledge.
Look, one of the things that I hear most often is like, how do I find the time to keep up? And luckily, one of the people that sponsors this channel, Beth Garrison with Opera and Coffee, her and Anesa Doyle stepped up to be able to create this thing called Research, Teaching, Application, and Technology. And it's pretty cool. Essentially, what they're doing is they're working with taking some behavior analysis, meshing it with technology to be able to curate and give you an article a week to go and check out. Anything that saves us a little bit of time, I'm really about. So I'm hoping you'll check it out. I make no money off of this plug. They just help support and make these videos happen. So it seems like a really good intersection. Like I mentioned, I'm not paid by anybody to talk about this. In fact, if you want to support this channel, help it grow, help it flourish, and you want to see more content like this, I need your help over at patreon.com/thedailyBA. This is where you can, in a values-based model, however much you want, help support this channel and help it grow and flourish. I lose money on this every month making this happen. The more people I can help support, the better. But only do it if you have the cash, please. If not, don't worry about it. There's a whole lot of perks, extra videos, merch, swag, stickers, things that I send out. We have a really special package going on right now. I'm gonna pop it up right here. And I'll see you in the comments. That's your daily beat.